everyone, welcome back to Pokemon Master EX. Today we have a very unique showcase because it is not an EX showcase, it is a normal one. Why? Because the character in question, as you can see, does not have an EX form. She is a very unique trainer because she is actually an NPC trainer from, I believe, Sun and Moon. She is the female Sightseer. She is one of the most popular NPCs together with the X-Maniac and other ones into the game. And I wanted to cover her because I do think that it is quite fun that we got such characters. This will be a little bit different compared to other showcases because the Sightseer does not have any kind of EX, she does not have a ton of strength as a character, so doing a Champion Stadium with her can be sort of a problem because at that point I will just be using the two other sync pairs to do most of the work and she will be just there to get the, let's say, count for the match. So I will just be doing a normal gameplay showcase. Also, she does not really have any sort of impressive animations and so on. Even in gameplay, she is a decent ground type sync pair, but nothing to write home about if you have anything better. So she's there for collection purposes and also to have quite a unique character into the game. To be simpler with the showcase, I will just call her Naomi from now on, since this is her name, even though she is the Sightseer, so that's technically her official, let's say, role into the main games and into this one. So she's called Naomi, and between brackets you can see Sightseer whenever you choose for her. Anyway, let's go into the analysis. As usual, we'll do analysis and then the showcase of everything else that you want to know. She does have a day with story and Pokémon-centered interaction, so that's pretty cool. And this is the generic team that I will use with her. So you can see quite the unique choices. We have Nita. Why do we have Nita? Well, very simply, if you guys do not ever or know where you can get her with the battle passes, and she has ground teamwork, which is a master sync per buff that uses the ground type as the counters to power it up. And then we have the trainer, the protagonist with my name, together with Kabutops, very simply to use Sandstorm, because she really benefits from Sandstorm, and I only had Acerola as my other Sandstorm user, so I wanted to change it up a bit, and I use an Eggmon as the Golem. So this is a very generic team. What you want to go with there is someone that can use Sandstorm, and then a support or a main DPS, depending on who enables the Sandstorm. She can't really be the main DPS for reason that we'll see in just a moment. But she is 5 out of 5, a freebie. You can get a ton of value out of her if you got her from the costume event that other on rate up. So, here we go. This is Naomi Sightseer, as you can see. She has Sandslash and she has a strike, special strike sort of build. So she can't really take many hits, she will die rather quickly into battle. However, a special attack is quite decent, the speed as well, attack, you don't really use it, and you can see that you have a sort of decent kit. We have X special attack to boost her offense, and then the trainer move, Vacation Vibes. This gives her speed plus 2 and critical hit rate plus 1. So, she is self-sufficient in offensive buff if you give her the time to do that, but generally you want to use another support to do that. You have a single target attack that lowers the target speed, and her power, which is her main attack, which lowers the target special defense. So generally speaking, you want to activate Sandstorm to activate all of her passive. As you can see, she's only used for Sandstorm in this department. Sand Shelter, Searching Sand powers up the user moves, and Sand Blaster powers up the user seek move during a Sandstorm. So Sandstorm, you always want it up. The sync move has no additional effect. Would have been good if she had extra damage if it was a Sandstorm, would have tied with the rest of her kit, but I guess it is fine. Because in terms of Syngrid, she actually has one, which is kind of surprising. You can get two very powerful tiles to power up her moves even more. Ramming Speed powers up the user moves the more the speed is raised, which you can do with a trainer move. And Brain Sync 3 powers up user sync move when its special attack is raised. So basically you want to raise up her stats and then go onto the offensive. Or have someone else raise her stats for her. You can always choose to power up either Earth Power or Mud Shot to get some useful type like the move Gauche Refresh, of course. And then this one on a roll can be quite useful to debuff the enemy in some situation. Like for example, if you have some enemy like Latias in the legendary arena that benefits a lot from lowering their stats with a debuff, that can be quite useful, or in general for long battles. So, what do I think about this Sync pair? This is quite a fast analysis because she's very simple. She's quite a decent single target attacker for the ground type if you have Sandstorm. Generally speaking, you will never use her if you have been playing this game for more than 2 years because you probably have way better ground types. Ingo, you have Maxi, you have Cynthia as well, you have a ton of different Sync pairs in ground that are way better than her. However, if you are looking for a very generic Sandstorm team and you want a sort of side DPS that can also debuff, she can be sort of useful. The fact that she dies very quickly, however, can be sort of a problem in high difficulty modes, which is why I didn't try my hand with her into the Champion Stadium, but you will see a more than worthy showcase regardless. For lucky skills, I suggest Critical Strike 2 or Weathered Warrior 3, I believe it is called, for obvious reason, because she always wants to get the bonus from Sandstorm, so she also gets the one from Weathered Warrior. For team skills, she only has Alola and sunglasses, so always go with ground is my suggestion here. Off type doesn't really seem like her forte in any way. But anyway, this is the analysis for Naomi. Hopefully you enjoyed it, even though I didn't really tell you much from what she is. But as I told you, she is a freebie character, so fairly simple. And if she gets an EX in the future and more tiles, I will be very happy to see where she can go with that. I also upgraded her to the max, so with all the 5 star tickets, etc. So you will see her most powerful form into battle. Now you will see the showcase, then the gameplay showcase. Enjoy the rest of the video. Remember to like and a sub if you do, and if you want to support the channel even more, you can always use the super thanks feature to support the channel with a donation and a comment of your choosing below the video. For me, for this commentary part of the analysis, it is over. Now enjoy the rest of the video with Naomi and Sandslash.
あなたについていったらすっごく楽しそう。というわけで、これからよろしくね。ポケモンにパワー注がれてない。バカンスなんだもん。楽しむしかないっしょ。レッツバカンス。私すっごい記念の自撮りいった。 し。よし、行くよ。お願いします。ねえねえ、これあなたにあげる。
私が勝つ。やるよ。
行こうよ。
一緒に行け。行くよ。行くよ。チャンス。チャンス。チャンス。そこ。
アドバイスしてもらえるかしら。